Watch what's approaching. The supreme moment. Reality striking closer than it seems, don't it? Go ahead, it's for the taking if you want it. If not, the dream dies and you'll be forever haunted. Then confront it.
What's good? I think a lot of you guys were highly interested in seeing this showcase, so today we're going to be testing out the 100% potential of the super physical type Arale unit on the variation of different categories and setups. But I don't know, like I've seen in the comments section quite a bit, it seems like you guys really wanted to see a max level link skill showcase with this unit, so we'll go ahead and test it out and see what happens. But before we get into the details, let's just go ahead and talk about how this unit never really came back around on any sort of banners. Like, at some point I figured she would be available along with the other units from, you know, the Penguin Village collab or whatever, that they would be in the general pull of SSR, similar to kind of like Dragon Ball Fusion's characters in a way, but it never came to be for whatever reason. So unless, you know, you're one of the older, you know, older age, dark ages type player, you really don't even have a copy of this unit. Some of you guys probably haven't even ever heard of it, so I think that's the context of the unit itself, a little bit of a background history. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get into the details and stats for the unit itself. Considering how old this unit is, just a reminder, this unit did come out on December 5th, 2016 on JP and May 11th of 2017 on Global. So again, that brings the point that this is a really old unit, and you know, the fact that it's not even available in the general pool is quite amazing and dumbfounded in a way. But out of the group of the Arale units, this one is probably the best out of the bunch. Just overall skill sets and whatnot is pretty solid. Leader skills, all types, key plus 3, HP, attack, and defense increase to 30%. So she actually surprisingly had a pretty good leader skill at the time of release. And then for the super attack, it will cause immense damage to enemy, and then you have a 30% chance of having the 100 times Nja cannon, which will cause immense damage to enemy with greater power. Now that greater power, according to the Dokkan wiki, will raise the SA multiplier by 60% during the super attack. However, it doesn't stack, so just keep that in mind. Passive skill is actually pretty good at the time of the release, and it's still pretty decent to this day as well. Attack increase of 120% when performing a super attack. Now in terms of like the link sets, you've got the Innocence at level 10, that is attack increase of 15%. Mechanical Menaces is key plus 1 and reduces damage received by 5%. Shocking Speed is key plus 2 and defense increase of 5%. Battlefield Diva is key plus 3. And chance of evading enemies attack including supers by 5%. Revival is key plus 2, attack and defense increase of 5%, and recovers 5% HP when HP is 50% or less. Penguin Village Adventure is attack increase of 20%, and finally Fierce Battle is attack increase of 20%. The category availability is a little bit limited. You have Artificial Lifeforms, Youth, and Dragon Ball Saga. Of course, considering link sets like Penguin Village Adventure, you do have to factor in, you know, the DB Saga or Youth. Those typically will house the units with those link skill, you know, setups. At 100% potential, you're looking at 14,818 for HP. Attack is 13,150 and defense is 10,375. 12 key multipliers, 140%. And again, this unit at the end of the day is very solid. Now, the one thing I think worth noting is defensive liability. She doesn't really see any sort of boost toward defense. Again, the passive skill is just a flat attack increase of 120%, nothing else. So of course, you do come across a little bit of a liability issue in today's day of Dokkan. You know, defense is a little bit more on the important side nowadays on the current state of Dokkan's meta, but that's certainly one of the easiest things to call out in terms of like the unit itself. Now, I think overall this unit did age relatively okay. Obviously, there's a lot of newer units, including free to play, that are, you know, substantially better from overall balanced setup. But you know, anywhere from like 2 million to potentially 2.5, 2.6 million in attack stats, I mean, that's, you know, pretty solid. I think at the end of the day, this unit's just purely offensive. You know, there's no sort of defensive setups with this unit necessarily. No built-in skill sets toward defense. It's just, you know, pretty much a powerhouse type deal. And, you know, considering how old this unit is, back in 2017, this little one was a pretty crazy little monster. We'll put it to you that way. And honestly, it's probably within one of my top tens in terms of like units in the game. I just personally love, you know, the segment where the crossover happens in the manga, where Goku ends up chasing General Blue into Penguin Village and kind of run into, you know, the characters there. So it was definitely very nice to see that in Dokkan Battle. I think, you know, that was kind of a nice touch. And again, it'd be great if they bring this back at some point on a banner, but, you know, it's just unseen since, you know, and it's just crazy that they never brought it back. But imagine this little one with a potential Extreme Z Awakening. Maybe they'll do that. If they bring back the units, maybe they'll assign Extreme Z Awakenings for all the characters, you know, and that would actually make things quite interesting. That's probably the best way to explain my thoughts in terms of like the unit itself. But I mean she's definitely solid. Again, defense is a little bit of a liability, but you know, it's not really something you would run on, you know, the hardest event or anything. It's more or less at this point a little bit of a trophy and a collector's item, so to speak. So again, I can't remember the last time the banner was available. I feel like it first released and then it came back one time, and that was pretty much it, if I remember correctly. So I know it's been several years since then, but I just don't understand why they never brought it back. Maybe it's because of, you know, the banner units being unpopular. Maybe they didn't generate enough revenue for Bandai or Akatsuki. I have no idea, to be honest with you, but you know, I personally really love the Arale character. It's kind of a nice gag character to have. So, you know, it's a lot of fun being able to run this unit on, you know, some of the throwback teams. But again, she could definitely use some improvements. But I think at the very least, you know, the level 10 links definitely do help a pretty decent amount. And again, I don't know if you would typically run this unit on any of the more relevant, you know, current teams. But you know, if you've been around for a while, I know you probably have a copy probably laying there, or at least one of the copies of, you know, the units from that banner. But again, I don't know. It's just, you know, the more I look at the card in action, the more I wish it would come back. You know, I think a lot of people would love to see that, especially considering, you know, back then the potential system didn't exist. So of course we didn't necessarily know we had to keep dupes and potentially reserve them for the potential pass or whatever. So I don't know, there's just, you know, hindsight's 2020. I wish there were certain things that I didn't do back then, but you know, nobody really knew the outlook of the future of you know, Dokkan Battle at the time, you know, with the categories and you know, potential systems, and you know, most recently the link scale level updates and stuff like that. So of course it's a good, you know, it's a good indicator that it's continuing to improve, but you know, some of these units definitely need to be brought back so people have a chance to at least, you know, pull a copy, if not get copies of dupes. But you know, who knows what the deal is. I mean, that's all there is to say about it, you know. I'm guessing those watching right now, because I've seen it a lot in, you know, a lot in the comment section asking about this showcase. So I think the interest is still there, you know, to a pretty high degree. It's just a matter of whether, you know, Bandai will end up doing anything about it. But I don't know. I guess at the same time, it kind of maintains an exclusivity factor to it, I guess. You know, the people that have been around for a while, you know, at least have one copy of one of the units that were in the banner. I think it was actually a guaranteed feature, if I'm not mistaken, for maybe a certain amount of times. Again, it's been several years, so I don't remember on top of my head, but, you know, it was looking back on it now, it was definitely a pretty iconic little banner. I wish I didn't take it as lightly. I might have summoned a little bit more heavily if I had known, you know, what was going to come about with it. So we'll leave it at that. But you know, by closing, we'll just say, you know, hopefully it does happen something in the future. But we'll see. All right. Well, that being said, I guess I'll catch you guys later. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it.